Okay, time has come now. Oil change time. This is how I do it. We open that. I've just got back from a long ride, so everything is horribly hot. Let's just get my... Ow. Ooh, it's still got oil. Try it with the 12. Put it on there, I can't see. My exhaust is hot, see? Does it fit nicely?
Yes.
Good. Make a mechanic of you yet. Put it straight. Okay.
That's loose.
Okay, just before you do it too far.
Eventually.
Look. Dirty engine oil. Ah. Now to get to the oil filter behind there. I need to get this cover off as well. Oh, I don't know. Okay. And then that packet there with the new one, I will get that later, it's fine, don't worry about that. Ah, that comes off. Okay. So easy when you have the right tools. And by the way, guys, if you also have a little Honda like this, ow, that is hot as hell. And it's the first time you're ever taking the factory fitted one off. Good luck with that, because it'll never ever happen. Only way I got the factory one off was with hammering a screwdriver right through the whole thing, and then you twist it off. Ow, hot, 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 hot. Ow, ow, ow. Ow! Oh, man, that's warm. And that is that. We let all the oil run out. Never seen your bike from this angle. Oh, that's exhaust. Hey. And then we'll come back later and close it all up and put new stuff in and then clean a bit. Right, so we return a little bit later. And all the oil is now finished dripping. So we can now, bit of a mess, clean it up later. So now, while you're busy, take the sump plug, just check it out, everything is still good, make sure that the washer is also good on there. Sometimes I just spin the washer around, like that, and if you just spin it around, it'll give it a better seal and you don't have to replace it. Give it a good wipe, get all the all the oil off and jam it back in the hole. 17 hours later. Right. Always remember, when you're putting a new oil filter on, take one of your new tins of oil, dab your finger in it like that, and run it around the seal. Okay, it's quite important, especially after cleaning that. Just run it, just to give... Must be good oil, my finger's quite slippery, feels much faster. Right. And then, once we've done that, I personally like to just pour a little bit into the filter as well. Just to let the new oil soak in, instead of having the pump work overtime to fill it all up. Make sure your threads and everything are clean and nicely wiped. Screw it all in before it leaks everywhere. There we go. Simple pimple. Then give it a bit of a tightness. Tighten up with this one. Put it on the edge where it's easier. Just be careful not to over tighten it, guys. How the hell they do it in the factory, God knows. But yeah. Very important, after your first ride, always check underneath the little filter to make sure that there is no oil leaking from there. Very common mistake there, and also your sump plug. Just double check that everything is nice and clean there and there's no oil leaking. And then you can start reassembling your little scooter. Everything's in nice and tight. The book says 3.5 liters, 3.7 to be exact. So this is just short of a liter. Let's get to pouring. You're probably wondering how I made this funnel. You can see it's part of a 500 milliliter drink bottle, and the lid is actually off a energy drink bottle. Just grab us another three there, as you can see there, and that just screwed in perfectly and it makes an awesome little spill free funnel. Miracles of editing again. And second bottle, and the third liter. Right, this is the last one, which is three, and I've got to put about 0.7. Look at that, 300 left. Right. Remember, when you're wiping this, don't use a dirty cloth on the inside. Okay, you don't want to contaminate the stuff inside there. And then what we can do is, while that's still filling up and settling and everything, and fire up the engine, let it circulate through everything. And now it's time to get the bike outside. We'll give it a power hose wash. And test ride, and we're all good. Whenever I clean my chain, the one thing I never take off is that to clean inside there, and that is a sticky, gooey, gunky mess of stuff inside there. This is the housing for it. Perhaps I should have cleaned that off one day. All those little stones are gonna get jammed in the sprocket and cause me to die one day. This is how we clean. Dusty, just give it time to build up pressure. Guys, I've always asked about my exhaust pipe. This is it in all its glory. That's my noisemaker. Okay, now we get to the fun part of cleaning the chain and everything else around it. This chain was done about a week ago, so I think with cleaning all the other gunk and everything out at the front sprocket, it's just filled this chain up. And I am using regular paraffin as a cleaner. Everyone says use it, so that's what I do, is I get it on there and I soak it in there very nicely. This cloth was clean like that when I started. Yeah, once we get to a stage where the chain is relatively clean, then I dig in there with a toothbrush and my chain cleaner, and yeah, we get the rest of it all clean. This is what I do have. This thing is old, filthy, yet still does a great job of getting into all those little grooves. The other one that comes around the other side, I was going to get that, but I don't actually like that. I prefer to get underneath like that, and that way you do both sides of the chain while you're cleaning. Okay, then I take a cloth, and don't forget your sprockets and most the shiny thing that everyone looks at. So I go and you move it a little bit, you move it a little bit, and you keep on cleaning it. Now the way that I know if I've got a clean chain is if you keep spinning it and there's no dirt left on the sprocket. I haven't oiled it up yet, but there will always be a little bit of dirt or paraffin or something left in the sprocket. But then again, after lots and lots of cleaning, you could end up with a cleanish rag or cloth or whatever you guys call it, and it should be relatively clean. Okay, it'll never be 100% a brand new chain, although it should be the best that you can get it. Yeah. Lots of hard work, these bikes. High maintenance. But this one, I'm still only halfway through, so... But it should be good after this. And always remember, always, never get your fingers caught inside here. Okay, Eds? Are you listening? Don't run the engine while your fingers are cleaning a chain. Not good. Okay, because then you end up with the stompy. Right, so we've cleaned everything in there. Put everything back together. Cleaned all the shock absorbers. Absorber. Chain is now nice and clean, but it's still very dry. Now I have a choice now. Do I use my Myrtle chain lube? Okay, cost a hell of a lot of money, 160 rand, that's about $3. And this one is a new brand on the market. It's more like an oil than anything else. Cost 40 rand, it's a handful of cents in US terms. I don't know, I think it's more of a locally made product, but yeah, this should, I don't know, I tried it and it's more quite oil based instead of lubricant sort of based, but let's see how it goes. Okay, just turn the wheel for me please, slowly, huh? Keep going a little bit quicker. Waiting for my chain marker to come past again. And one, there it goes. One more spin, a little bit faster for me, please. Okay, keep spinning it. That's a noisy one. Boom, boom. What I said the other day about bikes, four cylinders, scream. Two cylinders, growl. Three cylinders, just sound awesome. Just one more thing that I usually do once I've sprayed so much on. I'm not going to wipe it off, but just to get the excess lube off, I just gently wipe the outside of the chain. I'm not putting any pressure on it, just to run it through, just to clean it all. And that's it. Just to wipe any excess off. Always good to sit in the bottom and you can see where all the mess is. Look underneath here. This is all old lubricant from the chain that's splashing up underneath here. I've just seen it now. It's always good to get on your butt and look underneath. And as I said, paraffin. Spray some on the cloth. Best cleaner in the world. Give it a polish. Look at that. All of that grease has come off now. Like new. Thanks for watching, guys.